Contrary to popular belief, I don't think you should learn Python first. So, you want to start coding but don't know where to start. Nowadays, there's so much information out there that makes it hard to decide where to start. Look no further, because I got you covered. Now, programming languages have different uses. The one you pick should be the one for your use case. A lot of people will just tell you to learn Python. I think it's incorrect to identify a language you should learn first by its simplicity. You wouldn't code a mobile app in Python. You can, but you're making it harder on yourself by not realizing that there's different ways to go about it. Imagine you wanted to build an Android app. Popular languages for this use case are Java and Kotlin. There's also React Native. React lets you build a mobile website and turn it into an app. The main difference between something like Java and React is that React uses JavaScript, which is a completely different language than Java. I've noticed a lot of people get confused with Java and JavaScript because they both have Java in them. Remember, they are not the same. The name JavaScript came from Netscape's support of Java applets within its browser. A lot of people are saying that it was trying to capitalize off of Java's name, which was the most popular language at the time. Back to the question of what language you should use. Notice there are multiple approaches to creating or building something. Building an Android app in React is a completely different process than coding it in Android Studio with Java. There will always be different ways to do the same thing. I will show you what languages you should use depending on what you want to do. So, building a mobile app. This can be either for Android or iOS. Building a mobile app depends on which platform you're building it for. For iOS, the main languages to learn are Swift and Objective-C. For Android, as I discussed, I would use Java or Kotlin. For Android development, you can use the Android Studio IDE based on IntelliJ. For iOS development, Apple includes an IDE called Xcode, which includes all the emulators you need to simulate your app. If you want to create an app for both platforms and have one code base, I would use some sort of cross-platform library like React Native. This uses JavaScript and TypeScript. Building a website. Building a website requires you to learn the trifecta of web development: HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Now, HTML is not a programming language, and neither is CSS. JavaScript is a programming language. So why is HTML not a programming language, you might ask? Because it has no logic, therefore you can't code anything decisive. It's a markup language, the basic building blocks of your website. Once you learn these three, you can start getting into more advanced development using frameworks like React, Vue, and Angular. If you want to do backend in JavaScript, you can use Node. Node pretty much lets you do anything with JavaScript. You can build a server to take requests from your front end and it will be in the same language. JavaScript is versatile. While it doesn't have any typing, you can use something like TypeScript to add those. This means you have to define variable types before using them, making your development a little more bug-free. Once you have a good grasp on web development, you can build servers in whatever language you'd like. Building a GUI app or a desktop app. A GUI app is just like an application for desktop. Again, this is platform dependent and there are a lot of ways to go about it. You can use Java, C++, or Python. For Java, you would use Java Swing. For C++, you would use something like MFC, which will wrap the Win API wrapper and allow you to build desktop apps that look native to Windows. You can even turn one of your websites or web apps into a standalone executable using Electron. Electron is a Chromium browser wrapper for websites. Creating video games. Creating video games means you're using some sort of game engine. This can be something like Unreal or Unity. There are a lot of other game engines out there. You can even code your own game engine if you want. So the best languages to learn for all this would be any sort of C. C++ for Unreal Engine, C# for Unity. While C is a harder language to learn from the start, it will establish a lot of foundational knowledge that you need for learning other languages. Game development encompasses a lot of computer science skills. It's not just about downloading or creating the right assets. You have to be good at memory management to code the most efficient game possible. But game engines definitely do help with that. Creating game hacks. Anything involving memory manipulation or anti-cheat circumvention most likely uses C or C++. This is because C allows for precise memory management, and you need that while coding a cheat because you're manipulating live memory. Since most kernels are written in C, like Windows and Linux, this language will give you close access to the operating system, which you need while you code a cheat. You can learn a lot by finding that Aimtux repo on GitHub. This was an open source CSGO cheat coded for Linux, since Linux used to not have VAC. Creating apps for wearables, things like Apple Watch, Samsung Watch, etc. If you want to make an app for wearables, it's a similar process to developing a mobile app. For iOS, you want to learn Swift or Objective-C. For Android, you want to learn Java or Kotlin. The reason it's the same process is because it's almost the same platform, just with limited functionality and smaller screen sizes. Raspberry Pi projects. Raspberry Pis are great to get started with code. They are cheap computers and you can install Linux on them. If you want to code stuff for your Raspberry Pi, I definitely recommend Python. There are endless possibilities. you could create a Pi hole, turning your Raspberry Pi into an internet ad blocking hole for your network. I've used the Raspberry Pi before to create proxies for a web scraper. It's basically a mini computer. So I went over some of the more common things people want to code. What if you want to learn a language for your career? The same concept applies here. Since you'll eventually want to focus on one area of your career, you should pick what interests you and then learn the languages around that topic. Big tech companies use a bunch of different languages, so it's not really beneficial to randomly pick one. A lot of people don't realize that once you learn the concepts of one language, a lot of those concepts will transfer over to the next language. You just have to relearn the syntax, not all of the concepts. Don't get caught up in the confusion of picking a language to start. Just start. Pick something you're interested in and then pick a language around that topic and then just get into it. You can do it. A lot of viewers aren't subscribed to my channel. So if you're enjoying this content, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe.